right, some people have been asking me about my training recently for the hill climbs, so I thought I'd go through a little bit. So anyway, you can see here, this we're on Strava on the training log. I'm going to use Strava for the first week, and then the next two, I'm going to go back onto Training Peaks. So we had some efforts here. This is sort of bread and butter stuff, or bread and margarine stuff, as you could say. 504 watts, just like these 1 minute on, 5 minutes off. These are really good just to get your maximum 1 minute power. And then I tried to do some 2 minute intervals, and then basically gave up after doing a couple of those. So yeah, just really anaerobic stuff for this. Then I did some 2 minute intervals. So I did 2 minutes max, basically 432 watts. So not my best. Then I had a soft moment where I only did a minute. And then you see I have big recovery because you just want to hit maximal intensity. And 2 minutes, 425 watts. And then again, 9 minutes off. And then 2 minutes, 415 watts. And then 28 minutes off. And then 400 watts, 316. Now, I was supposed to do a couple more of these. These are like 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off. But they're good trainings. They really help. And then this was just like for a laugh. So I just wrote out the ash. You might have seen this video. I'll try and link it. I'm probably going to steal a bit of his footage from that because here's some good footage of me. The first one was Hudnall Lane, 363 watts, nothing crazy. 8 minutes, 300 watts. So basically, Ash just led me out, and then I tried to get a KOM, but mate, I have no form on this. And then I think, yeah, Bison, I tried to go full gas, and then I just ended up grinding home. But anyway, it was all a decent ride altogether, to be honest. Did some decent efforts, but nothing absolutely crazy. And I think it was like 155K day in the end, so can't complain. And anyway, now I'm going to go to Training Peaks, because before that, I haven't really had much structured training. So that was my first week of proper training. And then I basically have two more weeks. So now we have this week here. So just Monday, always recovery ride. And then this is what I've been doing this today on Tuesday and also last Tuesday. 1 minute 30s on about 400 or so watts. And then, you know, a recovery, long recovery section in between, about 17 minutes. So yeah, that is basically what I've been doing. A lot of anaerobic things and a lot of rest. So you can see here, we will have, we'll just scroll down here, but just have a look at them. This is the most important one, the average power. So you can see 414 watts, 430, 428, 427, 400, then 416, 416, 418. Am I missing any? No, that's it. So yeah, that was a solid one there. I think my goals for this one, I can't remember actually what my coach is Tom Bell. I try to leave a link for him as well. I often forget these links, so just remind me about them. I think, yeah, the intensity was about 400 watts to 420 watts. Yeah, 400 watts to 430 watts, which I think is about 125 to 135% of FTP. So yeah, that is good. 125 to 135%. Okay, so that was solid. And then you'll see 3 hours fasted rides. So these are just basically, they allow you to have a lot more stimulus and load your mitochondrial system to become a lot more efficient. Your mitochondria, sorry, to become more efficient in a shorter time. So it would be like, I mean, it's not an exact perfect, but imagine this is a 3 hour fasted ride. Maybe I have to ride 4.5 hours to get the same adaptations on my body. So that's why it's useful. And then as soon as I get home, I just eat. So that was all chill. Didn't bonk or anything. Again, an hour. They also helped me to lose weight a little bit, I think. And then pre-race openers. These are pretty hard, to be honest. I wasn't used to doing hard openers, but it definitely helped. So you can see just ramping up here, nothing crazy. I did do all these on the flat, so it's not the easiest. These actually hurt quite a lot. 2 minutes at threshold, 30 seconds full at 380 watts. I mean, they don't hurt, but you know, like they do hurt, but they're not crazy. Anyway, I have my two races on the weekend, so we can go into the power files of that, which I believe should be this one here. Yeah, I think it's this one here. It was like decent, but nothing crazy. So you can see like my max 1 minute power is 510, which is my second best for this year. Overall, I think I held for the whole thing. Well, let's just go from that part to where's my power start to drop off? 2 minutes 55, more or less. Yeah, at 434 watts. Oh no, that's normalized. Average 417. Yeah, so you know it's decent, but nothing absolutely crazy. My pedal obviously unclipped, as you can see on this big thing here. Rest of it was just commuting, very easy rides, very chilled rides. And then I had a hill climb again on the weekend. I should actually probably attach that workout, but I'll do that later. And then yeah, so this was again solid ride. We'll go into the number A's as well. Sorry, I'm not very good at Training Peaks. Well, I'm not too bad, but if you do actually want any tutorials on Training Peaks, I could try and give you little guides. Anyway, this is 4 minutes 40, which is the effort, 400 watts, more or less. And I was 61 kilos on the day. So that's the lightest I've been for a long time. Rest of it's commuting, just easy spinning. This week, this is basically my last week. So I'm going to university on Saturday, this Saturday here. So next week, I probably won't be riding that much, but I do have a race on Sunday. So I'm going to just take this as a rest week, pretty much. And then just start training like normal again. So yeah, you can see recovery ride, you know, a longer recovery ride, but still real easy. And then these 400 watt intervals, 430 watt intervals, I think they were maybe slightly better this week, but not, you know, mainly the same. So yeah, anyway, you have laps here. Again, just look at the average power one. So 418, 424, 425, 417. Then we had my rest, 406, 417, 409, and 419. So again, all in the target wattage. So yeah, content. 1 hour recovery ride, 4 hour ride here. I'll probably do the first 3 hours fasted maybe. Just try and get a bit more adaption, and then the last hour just eat, because I'm not sure if I'm up to a 4 hour fasted ride yet, but we will see. This just helps, you know, your endurance, helps your mitochondria to be more efficient. It does push up your threshold slightly, these endurance rides. And it's also just a good way of like making sure you burn lots of calories and stay lean. And anyway, these are my 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off. I prefer them to do on a climb, to be honest, because that's actually where they're more applicable. Unfortunately, I live in London, so trying to find it will basically be an 8 minute effort. Trying to find an 8 minute climb near me, it doesn't happen. I could get the train, but like that costs money and it takes time. So I'll just do them on the flat, these ones. So target interval, it's not crazy wattage. It's only 125%. I normally do these at 130 to 140%. So it's not gonna be mega hard, but I guess I'm doing three of them. So that will make them a little bit harder. But these again are good. I'll probably do them in a slightly bigger gear just to try and really like use my fast twitch muscle fibers more. So really trying to get that acceleration going, because that's really what you want to use. And then obviously you'll just have lactate through your eyes because you're doing VO2 max efforts. So yeah, that'll be a solid ride. And then I'm starting uni, so I'll just do an hour probably if that. And then Sunday, I'm not sure how much time I'll have slash what I'll be doing, because, you know, don't want to be antisocial and just ride my bike all day. But we will see. But anyway, on the plan is 6 minutes at 333 watts, 30 seconds hard at the end. These should be horrible, but not too bad. Like, they'll be doable. And that's the thing I'd say with my having a coach, is that they often don't make it as hard as you think they should be, but they make you train consistently and they make you do all the efforts. So like today, if I was doing 1 minute and a half efforts, if I was doing 1.5 minute efforts today, I'd probably like set 450 as like that's every interval, but that's just not gonna happen. So then you just feel demoralized and you don't hit the same intensity. Like, okay, on hill climbs, it's slightly different because you really wanna hit that high intensity. But even so, it's better to do like maybe 10 watts less or 20 watts less, but spend far more time on it than maybe only doing three intervals at 450 watts, but they're maximal. Like, it just depends really on what you're training at. At this moment in time, like obviously hill climbs, you want to be very close to maximal, but it makes more sense to just try and spend a bit more time. And so yeah, that is the plans for the last couple of weeks. And then yeah, we will have a rest week on this and then hit VC Walcott, which is about a 2 minute hill climb. On the Sunday. So anyway, cheers for watching. I hope this did help you if you're wondering what training I'm doing for hill climbs. I'm gonna make more videos on this because everyone seems to be buzzing on hill climb, Bike Radar doing videos on it. I feel like Cycling Weekly will probably do them. Like, everyone just seems to love these UK hill climbs, and I love them too. So yeah, I also have a video on my bike. It's almost ready, not 100%, still a couple things I need to just like sort out. But yeah, it's pretty light. I think it's about 7 kilos now, and I've still got a couple things to hopefully I'll be able to change and get it down to a 6.5 or so. I mean, people have 5.5 kilo bikes, so it's not mega, mega light, but hopefully it should help. And then, yeah, we will be gearing up for the Nationals on the 28th of October, which will be a big day up for me. And if you haven't seen, I'll post my other videos about these races, the Lovello Cinelli, I think it's Lovello Cinelli RT Hill Climb. I finished like 30th then, unclipped, not great. And this one, I finished 8th actually. I thought I finished 9th, but I finished 8th. So my first top 10 in an open hill climb, which is pretty good. So anyway, cheers for watching. I'll see you next time.